I like reading books on the benefit that IT and technology has on a social environment and how we look to or perceive to be needing to adapt for the future as well. I am Maryam. My area of responsibility is robotic cognitive automation and transformation. I've graduated with a software engineering degree, and my focus area is around the software that we use. It's the bots, we call them, that help give back time actually to our associates. What gets me excited to come to work is being able to be working with experts that we have within my team and just showcase, just to show, look, this is how these technologies work and this is what we've done in other areas of the organization. You can start to see the excitement in the room, and all of a sudden it elevates the discussion into an area where you can do something to help folks or teams like this. I have two sons, and both my boys have an interest in IT. The younger one, he's more into the designing aspect of software. So we've been at home playing around with designing chatbots. We tend to start off on paper, which is really, really good because we can just play around looking at how we can ask a question in several different ways, which is interesting for him. My oldest son, he's in the College of Informatica, and the conversations that we tend to have are very techie. So he's learned something at college and he comes home and says, "Mom, this is the cool stuff I've learned today. Do you know about that?" So then I'll be quizzing him back. When he's limited to his knowledge, I get a point, of course. And then if he has told me something, of course he gets a point. I'm very hopeful for the future from a gender bias perspective, because when I listen to the discussions that my kids are having, gender's not a topic. It doesn't matter who the person is for them. You know, gender, color, creed, doesn't really make a difference. It's more about what value you bring to the work that you do or the activity that you're undertaking.